In this lesson, we will discuss arrays that have two or more dimensions. These type of arrays are often called matrices. Arrays can contain up to 60 dimensions. For every dimension in an array, an index number must be specified. Most engineering problems only require using one or two-dimensional arrays. In this tutorial, we will focus on two-dimensional arrays, but the concepts can easily be extended to higher dimensional arrays as well. When you declare a two-dimensional array, you must specify two numbers. The first number determines the number of rows in the array, and the second number determines the number of columns in the array. Dim C1, 2 as double creates a 2x3 array named C that stores numbers with decimal points. Each element has a row and column index number. The top left element is in row 0, column 0. The bottom left element is in row 1, column 0. And the bottom right element is in row 1, column 2. Here are the row column addresses for the remaining elements. When a numerical array of any dimension is declared, each element is initially assigned the value 0. We can change the values in each array element by specifying the element's row and column indices. C0, 1 equals 7 assigns the value 7 to the element in row 0, column 1. C1, 2 equals 10 minus C0, 1 takes the quantity of 10 minus the value of C0, 1, which is 10 minus 7, or 3, and assigns that to the element C1, 2. When you want to access all elements in a multidimensional array, you should use nested loops. You will need one loop for every array dimension. For a two-dimensional array, like in this example, you will need two loops. When we run this macro, six values will appear in the workbook. Let's discuss why these values appear. Option base 1 forces the lowest index number for all dimensions to be 1 instead of the default value of 0. Inside the macro named main, two constants are created. NRow, which is assigned the value 2, will store the total number of rows in the array C. NCol, which is assigned the value 3, will store the total number of columns in the array C. A two-dimensional integer array named C is created. It will have two rows and three columns. The variables I and J will be used to go through every element in the array named C. We want to access every element in the array C and assign a value to it equal to the row number times 2 plus the column number squared. In order to access every element in C, we will use nested loops to go through all possible row-column combinations. I will be used to refer to the row number, and J will be used to refer to the column number. The outer I loop is used to vary the row number, and the inner J loop will vary the column number. When we begin the I loop, I is assigned the value of 1, and it will increase by 1 each time the next I statement is executed. Since N row is 2, the I loop will terminate when I becomes 3. Inside the I loop, we reach the J loop. J is assigned the value of 1 and increases by 1 after each next J statement is executed. Since NCol is 3, the J loop will terminate when J becomes 4. Now we reach the statement Cij equals I times 2 plus J squared. I and J are both 1, so this statement becomes C1, 1 equals 1 times 2 plus 1 squared. And the resulting value, which is 3, is assigned to element C1, 1, 1. Next j increases j by 1, and j is now 2. J is still less than n call, so we again execute the statement Cij equals I times 2 plus j squared. Since I is 1 and j is 2, this statement becomes C1, 2 equals 1 times 2 plus 2 squared. And the resulting value, which is 6, is assigned to the element C1, 2. The j loop is repeated one more time with I equal to 1 and j equal to 3. The value 1 times 2 plus 3 squared will be assigned to C1, 3. When j becomes 4, the j loop is terminated, and we reach the next I statement. Notice that the row number I stayed constant at 1, while the column number j varied from 1 to n call. So far, we have assigned a new value to each element in the first row of C. I now has the value of 2, and we again proceed through the I loop, since I is not greater than n row. Inside the I loop, we reach the j loop again, and j is reset to 1. J will vary from 1 to 2 to 3, and the loop will be broken when j is 4. After this j loop is terminated, we will have assigned a new value to each of the elements in the second row of the array C. Next I increases I by 1, and I now has the value of 3, which is larger than n row, and this breaks the I loop. We now are going to write all of the values in the array C to the workbook. We select cell A2 on sheet 1 to start. We again use nested for loops to advance through all the elements in the C array, starting at element 1, 1, and finishing at element 2, 3. Inside the nested loops, the value of I and J are both 1 initially. The value stored in element 1, 1 in the array C is assigned to the current active cell, which is A2. The active cell is then moved one column to the right to cell B2. Next J increases J to the value 2, and we again enter the J loop. The value stored in element 1, 2 in array C is assigned to the current active cell, which is B2, and the active cell is then moved one column to the right and is now C2. Next, J increases the variable J to 3, and we once again enter the J loop. The value stored in element 1, 3 of the array C is assigned to the current active cell, which is C2. And then the active cell is advanced one column to the right and becomes D2. Next, J increases the value of J to 4, and the J loop is then broken. We now want to write out all the values in the second row of the array C. We need to move the active cell down one row and back n call number of columns to the left. I is increased by 1 and now has the value 2. We enter the I loop again, and now j will vary from 1 to 3 while I is fixed at 2. If you feel you understand this example, try changing n row, n call, and the equation to something else, and predict what the output will be.